Hi everybody, thank you so much for joining me today. I'm Dr. Tahir. I am making this video today to give you a summary of what's happened in my life over the past 4 to 5 years. The last videos that I had made for this channel were back in about 2017. And since that time, a lot has happened, and I'm going to just give you like an update on that. And also, this is my first video that I'm making back on this channel, so I'm excited about this. And I'm excited about getting back into teaching and talking to parents about their children and educating them on common things that all parents struggle with their kids, be it newborn babies to teenagers. At that time when I was making the videos, I had my own office and I had a different set of resources. I could just see a patient and ask them, hey, are you interested in making a YouTube video with me for educating other families? And many parents loved it. And so that's how a lot of the videos came about. You might have noticed they're all unscripted, kind of on the fly. There's really no script that I had planned, but we just made the videos. And over this time, I am just shocked to see how many people have commented on the videos and have found those videos useful. During this time, I was also going through a lot of difficult things with my family. So my wife, lovely woman that I was married with for many, many years. She was diagnosed with metastatic breast cancer in 2007. That was a day that changed our lives quite a bit. My two girls at that time were very young, about 3 and 4 or so at that time. From that moment on, our lives were very different. And thankfully to the miracle of medicine and all the different treatments that are available and all of the excellent doctors that were available to her, she lived very well and we made the most of every single day. I know that it was not just all medicine. I know that at least 50% of her life and survival and the way she lived was purely based on her inner peace and spiritual strength, her trust in God. During all of those years, I also learned a lot from her, and I'm forever thankful that she was in my life and brought two beautiful children in the world to us. And so she passed away in 2017. That was October in 2017. Since that time, there have been lots of changes, of course, that have happened in life. I have worked very hard to gather myself together and find new paths in life. My girls are much older now, 18 and 21 years old. And so during these past 4 years, not only have I learned to start taking care of myself better, self-care, stabilize our household, figure out what new paths hold in my life. I've also worked very hard to take care of my daughters, and I've learned to become a better parent than I ever was before. And so a lot of the lessons I have learned from raising teenage girls, I hope to convey to you as time goes on. But I am thankful for my girls' presence in my life. And I'm also thankful for all the resources that I have had for myself, be it family members, friends, and also grief counseling, which helped tremendously to help figure out some of the difficulties that one might experience and learn how to handle them. So if you are ever in a situation such as this or different loss, please remember to be watchful of yourself and your family members, your kids, anybody else who's around, and to make sure that you take care of everybody. So one of the big things that I had done for myself was I had decided that I have to make sure I stay active in life, I stay social, I keep talking to people, I keep meeting friends, and I keep doing things. And I did that, and it was difficult initially, but as time went on, I really enjoyed it, and I've met just beautiful new friends and new people, and have made countless friends that I'm grateful for. So I'm thankful I was able to do that. I also found a lot of peace in nature. So early on, I didn't know why, but whenever I went hiking, I found intense peace. I had never really been an outdoorsy person before, but the more I walked, the more I went around, the more I felt peaceful, and I couldn't understand why. Whenever I was in trees, amongst trees, I felt this intense peace, and by water, I felt incredible peace. And as time went on, I started learning about this and realized that I'm not unique in any way. This happens to a lot of people. Nature is a healing place, and being in nature is healing for a lot of people. There's just beautiful energy all around. Being in nature and exposed to nature exposes you to that. So for me, that was a very nice part of my growth over time. I also learned to love water. I love being on water, around water. And so I went kayaking one time just for fun, and I just absolutely loved it. And of course, then I bought kayaks. And so I spent a lot of my time going kayaking in all different rivers and lakes around the area. And then with one of my friends, I went paddleboarding. It was the greatest thing in the world. So then I bought a paddleboard. And so now I spend most of my time paddleboarding if I'm on water. I like that even better than kayaking, because you're real close to water and even closer to nature like that. So I've also been loving to learn about native plants, and also helping to encourage pollinators survive, and I'm enjoying learning about conservation. So there's lots of new things that I have gotten myself involved with, and some old stuff too. Long ago I used to love making robotics and electronics, but I realized I don't like too much analytical stuff moving forward. So I kind of tried that again a little bit, but didn't feel too comfortable. But one thing I really did get back into was art. When I was younger, back in high school, I used to draw, and a lot of my siblings draw, and my mom was an art teacher when I was younger, so my art comes from my mom's side of the family. So I used to draw, and then I thought to myself, maybe I should try drawing again. And so I got paper, I got pencils, and I drew trees, and I couldn't believe how nicely I could draw. It was shocking, and it was intensely, intensely relaxing. And so I started drawing trees mostly, and nature drawings, and they're pencil drawings. Let me pull one up. I have some hanging around here. Actually, I'm just going to pull one down and show you one of my favorite ones real quick. You see, here's one of them, okay? So this is one of my latest ones that I drew. This is a pencil drawing. So this is a forest view with a tree, and the leaves look like they're on fire, but they're not on fire. And it kind of shows how the tree and the energy of the tree is interconnected with everything around. So this is just one of the drawings that I did, and I'm really liking it. So I framed it and hung it up in the house so I can see it. And so I guess one of the things that I learned is one of the most important things that I had to do was learn about self-care. I took care of the kids, I took care of my family, my household, but I also had to learn about self-care and making sure that I'm spending time to take care of my mental health, of my creative needs, drawing, relaxing. And so I've gone through different jobs now, and the current job that I have is just fantastic. I love working with families and kids. And the type of job that I have is where now I have some days off that I'm able to spend really taking care of myself and my family and kids, being outside in nature, drawing, reading, learning, and most importantly, back to making some really fun and educational videos. So that's just a little recap of my life over the past 4 to 5 years. I invite you to please take care of yourself, spend time on yourself. The better health that you are in, the better you'll be able to take care of your children also, and your kids and your family. So make sure that you take time for yourself. I thank you very much for joining me again today. And I want to say thank you to all of the people that have been watching these videos across the world. I had no idea this was going on, and I recently looked on my channel and to see if anybody's watching any of the old videos, and I was just absolutely shocked to find there are people all across the world watching videos, commenting, liking them, and really finding them useful. So that gives me a lot of new energy and new purpose, and I'm just so excited to share things again with everybody and all the parents who are learning to raise their kids. You know, kids are not born with a little manual, and so there's always challenges. There's challenges as a parent, there's challenges as a doctor, and so even though I'm a pediatrician, I go through the same challenges that all parents go through as part of being a parent. So thank you again for joining me today, and thank you for letting me fill you in on my life. Be well and have a wonderful day. Bye-bye.